Hi, today we're going to be looking at 5 essential apps for medical professionals in South Africa. I'm Manithan Ryan, a medical doctor with more than 20 years of experience in the healthcare industry. So let's get to it and look at these 5 essential apps. These 5 apps that I'm reviewing today are recommendations by colleagues and apps that I've used myself. 2 of them are South African-based apps specific for the South African market, and the other 3 are international-based applications for health professionals. The first app we're going to be looking at is EMGuidance. EMGuidance is a South African-based app. The app developers have taken into account the South African market, and if you're a doctor or health professional, you can download and use the app. The app has 5 sections. You've got a discovery section, a library section where you've got medicines you can use, and guidelines. So the guidelines you can add, it depends on where you are situated, so you don't have unnecessary guidelines downloaded onto your phone. Emergency medicine Western Cape is here, the gynecological department of Wits, standard treatment guidelines available as well. Then you go to the tool section. This is quick reference tool for Glasgow Coma Scale, for example, or Parkland's formula for a burns patient. You've got the weight, the body surface, and have 25 kilos, 20 gives you the fluids. This will help for paramedics on the road, as well as emergency care doctors. The learning section, you've got CPDs, you can get CPD points, drug interactions can be reviewed. The discover, you can search medicine and guidelines. For example, let's look at UTI. So there we are, searches for you and gives you a whole lot of information of UTI. It's even got ICD-10 coding. There's the ICD-10 coding with the treatment of UTI, a quick reference. So a very helpful app indeed. Next, we move on to Vula. Vula is a South African app. I've not registered to this app, but let's go through the registration process. Put in your name, your surname, your location. So if you belong to KwaZulu-Natal, and you put the type of professional you are. If you're an ambulance assistant, your registered number you can put in there. Then you look for the department. If you work in Hillcrest, so you can go to Busamed Hillcrest. So you'll be put on to the emergency medicine department of Busamed. This app is really beneficial as you're able to quickly make referrals to the doctor on call. So both the referring healthcare worker or the specialist or registrar that's receiving the patient will be able to get all the information necessary to advise whether to refer the patient or further management. It is definitely beneficial to the healthcare system as referrals are then quicker, especially since the referring doctor may be in theater, seeing a patient, be involved in a resuscitation. You can always look at the referral once he's finished with the resus. The app that I find very useful, especially in an emergency, is the Anesthesiologist application. It's very useful when you're on the road or in theater, especially for rural doctors. If you're doing a cesarean section or a procedure where you require general anesthetic, so you can quickly put in the information. If you've got a 25-year-old, in this case, weight of 75, you put in the details, you get your answers. So if you click intubation, as a quick checklist will help you ensure that you practice safe medicine, have your drugs ready, and you anticipate any complications. Because with anesthetics, it's anticipating the complications and then being able to act fast enough to ensure that you are able to manage the complications. So as you can see, you've got your mask size, medium to large, your LMA, size 5, your blades, the ETT tube, 6 to size 7 cuffed, at 18 to 22 centimeters. Then we go down, we look at the drugs that you need. So here's all the dosages, 75 to 150 of fentanyl, propofol, 150 to 230. The emergency drugs, your succinylcholine, 4 to 5 milligrams per kg, so you need to keep 300 to 380. It goes on, it's got all your emergency drugs, ketamine if you're on the road. And the other section which I like is the section for regional blocks. So they've got a YouTube link. Just click directly if you want to do a femoral block, for example. It takes you directly to the page and you can watch and do an ultrasound femoral block. Next, we go on to MD Calc. EM Guidance doesn't have a full list of calculations. So an ABG analysis, for example, let's look at
pH was 7.3. Your PCO2, let's put it as 41. So your result is primary respiratory alkalosis. Let's look at all. There's an acute gout diagnosis rule, risk for gout. There's a age-adjusted D-dimer to rule out a VTE. So when to use it, pitfalls, why use it. This is also a very useful app.
The final app we're going to look at is the X-ray interpretation app. This app is applicable to medical practitioners, medical students, radiographers, nurse practitioners, and clinical associates. It really goes into depth explaining the X-rays. It gives you a view of the different type of X-rays. If you want to go to a specific system in the body, you can go to the app and look at it. And then here's the other system, and you will have an idea on how to diagnose. So let's go through it now and have a look. Thank you for joining me today looking at the five different applications for medical professionals in South Africa. If there's an application you feel that's worthy of mention, please put it down in the comments below. If you like what you heard today, press the like button. If you want to hear more content of this nature, press the subscribe button. I'll see you soon.